بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد So inshallah ta'ala In this evening we carry on with the tafsir of Ibn Kathir May Allah have mercy upon him And as we have mentioned previously The tafsir that, or the parts that we're going to go through inshallah ta'ala Is the tafsir juz amma And we have stated the reasons behind choosing Juz Amma. Because majority of the Muslimin, they know Juz Amma. Also, Amma Yatasa'aloon and other surahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the intellectual and the logical proofs for his existence. Likewise, for him to be singled out in worship alone. And also proving with intellectual proofs and the logical proofs for Yawm al-Qiyamah, for the day of resurrection, also for the Nubuwa, for the prophethood. So, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala mentioned, of course, Juz Amma, the first chapter of Juz Amma, is the chapter Amma Yatasa'aloon. Amma Yatasa'aloon عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون ألم نجعل الأرض مهادا والجبال أوتادا وخلقناكم أزواجا وجعلنا نومكم سباتا وجعلنا الليل لباسا وجعلنا النهار معاشا So as for the first ayah عما يتساءلون What they asking about? What? Or what they are asking about. What they are asking about. عن النبأ العظيم. Are they asking for the, or are they asking about the great news? النبأ العظيم, the scholars have differed concerning the meaning of النبأ العظيم. Some of them mentioned that النبأ العظيم meaning day of judgment. Are they asking about day of judgment? Some scholars mentioned about the Quran. About النبأ العظيم here, meaning Al-Quran. And there is no contradiction between the two meaning anyway. Why? Because I believe I mentioned that before, there's two types of tafsir, or ikhtilaf. So there's two types of ikhtilaf. There is ikhtilaf tanawwu' or ikhtilaf tadad. There's ikhtilaf which is the contra-distinction. Contra-distinction meaning the different of opinions even though they do not oppose one another. This is called contradistinction. Contradistinction. That is different from the opinions which contradict the opinions which contradict one another. So the verse could be both the meaning of it about the Quran and likewise about the day of judgment. Because the Arab pagans They were asking about Yawm al-Qiyamah because they rejected Yawm al-Qiyamah. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala mentioned about them, وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ That nothing will destroy us except time. Nothing will destroy us except time. And this is something which is, subhanAllah, even our time, the atheist, al-malahida, like last week I was speaking to one of them, They believe just because of time, anything can happen. Literally, I was speaking to one of them. He said to me, he believes there is a small amount of possibilities that he can turn to potato, that he can turn into his own mother. And this, maybe it's all of us, we are very surprised about it. Because how someone can believe that there is a small amount of possibilities that he can turn to potato, or he can turn into his own mother. But this is the outcome of atheism. If you believe in atheism, atheism, the meaning of it, that we are here or we came about just by chance. Just the reaction of chemical and matter. That's the reason we are here. And if this is the case, therefore anything can happen. So therefore, when the atheist starts speaking about ash-sharr wal-khayr, the good and evil, that doesn't make any sense according to atheism principles. Because according to atheism principles, that they put a view how this universe came about, it's by chance. So where did you get this concept of good or bad? So imagine if you see a fridge or a wind cause a fridge to drop on a chair, you're not going to call that evil or good. Likewise, whatever occurs between mankind, according to atheism principles, as one of the philosophers, a French philosopher, as Shahidu min Aliyah, he's among them, but what he testified is true. He said there is no true atheist. لا يوجد ملحد حقيقة. And that is true, there is no true atheist. A true atheist means there is no good or bad. Everything by chance, and if it can happen. And this is what they say, ما يهلكنا إلا الدار. Nothing will destroy us except time. Nothing will destroy us except time. So Ibn Kathir, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, meaning, what are they asking about? They are asking about the matter of the Day of Judgment. And it is the great news. And it is the great news. Meaning the dreadful, horrifying, overwhelming information. الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ مُخْتَلِفُونَ. About which they are in disagreement. They differ. And yes, the Arab pagans, they differed about the Day of Judgment. Likewise, they differed about the Quran. So as we have stated, that it could be the verse could be both, meaning that they are asking about the day of resurrection, also they are asking about the Quran. الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ مُخْتَلِفُونَ, meaning the people are divided into two ideas about it. There are those who believe in it and those who disbelieve in it. Then Allah threatens those who deny the Day of Judgment by saying, كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ. Allahu Akbar. Nay, they will come to know. Nay, again, they will come to know. Meaning they will come to know about the reality of Day of Judgment. The day that which they are different about. The day which they are asking about. And even us, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless all, we have to prepare ourselves for Day of Judgment. One day we're going to die, sooner or later. And as Imam bin Baz, may Allah have mercy upon him, have stated, how many people left their houses, they never come back? How many people won't sleep, they never wake up? How many people that we know of, they won't sleep and they didn't wake up, gone? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the souls. How many people left their houses? They couldn't make it back to their houses. So we have to prepare ourselves for the Day of Resurrection. We are living in a time, even those who practice, طغت عليهم المادة. كما قال Imam Al-Albani, may Allah have mercy upon him. طغت عليهم المادة. We became materialist, subhanallah. We care, and our main concern about dunya. There is no harm to look nice, to beautify yourself. This is our deen. Inna Allah jameen yuhibbul jamal. Allah is beautiful and He loves beauty. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no harm. However, this is not our main target. The main target is Jannah. So we have to prepare ourselves for the day of resurrection before it's too late. You know? And the way to prepare yourself for the day of resurrection, to have good friends around you. To have a good friends around to have good friends around you. As-suhba al-khayyira. Good friends. As the Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-mar'u ala deeni khalilihi. فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَحَدُكُمْ مَنْ يُخَالِلْ. That the man is upon the religion of his friend. So be aware who is your friend. كَمَا قَالَ الشَّاعِرُ لَا تَسْأَلْ عَنِ الْمَرْءِ وَأَبْصِرْ قَرِينَهُ فَإِنَّ الْقَرِينَ بِالْمُقَارَنِ يَقْتَدِي. Do not ask about the person. Do not ask about the person. Rather, watch out who does he hang around with. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَيَعْلَمُونَ. Nay, they will come to know. Nay, again, they will come to know. This is a severe threat and direct warning from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to all of us, not just to those who reject the day of resurrection, to all of us that will come to know, especially in Ramadan, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. Ramadan, shahr mubarak, shahr al-tawbah, شهر الرحمة، شهر الأعمال الصالحة، شهر الرجوع إلى الله تبارك وتعالى. The month of Ramadan is the blessed month, the month of mercy, the month of forgiveness, the month of repentance, the month for us to turn back to Allah تبارك وتعالى. So we should utilize it. عليكم السلام وبركاته. We should utilize the month of Ramadan to get closer to Allah تبارك وتعالى. كما قال إمام بن عثيمين رحمه وتعالى رمضان مدرسة ربانية رمضان مدرسة ربانية. The Ramadan is the is divine school. Ramadan is a divine school. Ramadan teaches you how to cultivate yourself upon righteousness, upon worship of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Why? Because إذا كان سهل عليك لكي تبتعد عن الأكل والشرب ومجامعة زوجتك وهو حلال في رمضان فمن باب الأولى أن تبتعد عن الحرام. سبحان الله. So if it is easy for you to stay away from drinking water or anything that is halal for you, or to eat food, or to have intercourse with your wives or with your wife during Ramadan, then it is more, will be more easier for you to stay away from the muharramat, from that which, from disobedience, from unlawful things. And the hikmah of Ramadan was one of the main wisdom of legislating Ramadan, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, in order to gain righteousness and piety. Then Ibn Kathir, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, mention Allah's power and the proof of his ability to resurrect the dead. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked to this, the Quran. That's why the best and the powerful logical argument is in the book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The simple and the powerful and the best logical, rational, intellectual arguments is in the book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. But for whom? For those who understand that. Not for those who have been drowned with philosophy. It would be too hard for them to understand the book of Allah, or to understand the intellectual arguments in the book of Allah. But those who have been raised and those who are attached to the book of Allah, to the Sunnah of the Nabi alayhi salam, to the way of the Sahaba and the Tabi'een and the Tabi'een, Allah please with them all. Then Allah will open their chest to understand the adil al-aqliya wa al-naqliya wa al-barahin al-aqliya al-qati'a in the book of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So after Allah mentioning that they are in doubt about their resurrection, Allah is going to prove to them why Allah is able to establish their judgments and to bring them back to life. Allah said, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا. Then before that, look at this, he said, then Allah begins to explain his great ability to create strange things and amazing matters. He brings this as a proof of his ability to do whatever he wishes concerning the matter of the hereafter and other matters as well. And just something I want to mention, a side point. Allah does whatever he wishes according to his wisdom. According to his wisdom. لأن الله أفعال الله مبنية على المشيئة ليس على المشيئة وحدها على المشيئة والحكمة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and other asifat, of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's actions is based upon his will and his wisdom, likewise ability, likewise mercy, likewise justice. So don't let the people of kufr wa ilhad yatala'abuna bik. مثلا يقول لك إذا الله له القدرة الكاملة, إذا الله يستطيع يفعل ما يشاء وهو قادر على كل شيء, هل الله قادر على أن يخلق إله مثله؟ هذا تلاعب والعياذ بالله, هذه تلاعب. لأن الله قادر يفعل بكل شيء بحكمته, وهذه هذا متناقض هذا السؤال. لأن إذا الله خلق إله فهذا ليس إله, لأن الإله ليس بمخلوق. فالسؤال نصف السؤال الأول ينقض أو ينقض سؤال نصف السؤال, نصف الثاني ينقض نصف السؤال الأول. هذا تلاعب السقسطائيين, هذا ليس له أي حقيقة في الخارج. هذه كلمات يتلاعبون بها. لأن إذا الله خلق إله فهذا ليس إله أصلا, فالإله الذي لا يخلق. ف some people they say we have to be careful when we say about Allah's actions, because Allah's actions, as we have stated, based upon his attributes, the justice, will and ability. For example, the sophistaiyun, sophistries, they say, and who are the sophistries or sophistaiyun? Those who used to ask questions just to cause confusions. Even the questions they used to ask doesn't make any sense, doesn't exist in the reality. For example, they say, if you believe Allah is able to do all things, is Allah able to create another God? This question doesn't make any sense, because by definition, God is uncreated. So if Allah creates another God, that God is not God anymore. It doesn't make any sense to begin with. But we see Allah is able to do all things according to his wisdom. Now, so the Shaykh Barakallahu Fikum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on say, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا. Have you not made the earth as a bed, meaning an established, firm and peaceful resting place that is subservient to them? Subservient to them. وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادًا. And the mountains as pegs, meaning he made them as a pegs for the earth to hold it in place, make it stable and firm. This is so that it might be suitable for dwelling and not quake with those who are in it. Then Allah says, وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. So of course, the earth is stable. The earth is stable. Allah made it in order to not quake with those who are in it. Then Allah said, وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. And we have created you in pairs, meaning male and female. Both of them enjoin each other. And by this means, procreation is achieved. Procreation is achieved when there is a marriage between male and female. This is what Allah legislated, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. And we have created you in pairs. Now, this is similar to Allah's statement, وَمِنْ آيَاتِي أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. And among his signs is this, that he created for you wives from among yourselves, that you might find repose in them, and he has put between you affection and mercy. لذلك الزواج يكون مبني على الرحمة والمودة. Marriage should be based upon love, mercy, you know, and forgiveness, especially as Muslims. You're not perfect. Likewise, your wife is not perfect. So you have to overlook the mistakes of each other. Some people complain about their wives, or some wives complain about their husbands. But none of us, we are perfect. We're not perfect. we are not infallible. So we should understand that the purpose of marriage, and we have to understand that we should look the mistakes of each other. I mean, generally speaking, we as a man, we complain a lot about our wives, but we are not perfect and we make many mistakes. Now, so the وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah is mentioning here, Allah is mentioning the athar of His rububiyyah, the signs and the effects of His lordship. That if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to create you from nothing, if Allah is the one who created everything, then logically speaking, is able to bring you back to life. Is able to bring you back to life. وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا. And we have made you sleep as a thing for rest. Now, meaning a stop of movement in order to attain rest from the frequent repetition and going about in search of livelihood during the day. A similar ayah has been mentioned previously in Surah Al-Furqan, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا. And we have made the night as a covering. As a covering. Meaning it is a shade and darkness covers the people. This, as Allah says, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا. By the night as it conceals it. Qatada. Qatada, one of the scholars of the Tabi'een, was known to be scholars from among the scholars of Tafseer. Qatada commented concerning Allah's statement, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا. And we have made the night as a covering, meaning a peaceful residence. Concerning Allah's statement, وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. And we have made the day for livelihood. This is from the ayat, from the signs. And ask people who work at night time. Those who work at night, they will tell you it's completely different. You know, regardless how much you sleep during the day, you always feel tired, generally speaking. Why? Because Allah made the night for sleep, not the day. And even working for night for a long period, that can affect you mentally. So it can play with you psychologically. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created night for us to sleep. Yes, our necessity, sometimes we have to work at night. I work at night, sometimes I do work at night. But, the asl is to work during the days. Or during the day, not at night. Except our necessity then, this is which is, but that's the asl, the shed, that is the asl. Meaning we made it radiant and shining so that the people would be able to move about in it. By it they are able to come and go forth their livelihood, earning businesses, dealings, and other than that as well. In reference to Allah's statement, وَبَنَيْنَا فَوْقَكُمْ سَبْعًا شِدَادًا. We have built above you seven stronger, the heavens, meaning the seven heavens in their vastness, loftiness, perfection, precision, and adornment with both stable and moving stars. وَجَعَلْنَا سِرَاجًا وَهَّاجًا. And we have made therein a shining lamp, meaning the radiant sun that gives a light to all of the world. Its light glows for all of the people of the earth. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنْزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ مَاءً ثَجَّاجًا. نعم, وَأَنْزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ مَاءً ثَجَّاجًا. And we have sent down from the mu'sirat water ثَجَّاجًا. ثَجَّاجًا. So, we stop here inshallah ta'ala, and we carry on maybe tomorrow inshallah ta'ala with the rest of the ayat from Surah Amma يَتَسَأَلُونَ, Surah Naba. And this is a powerful surah for us to read it, understand it, reflect upon it, and implement it. That's how we read the book of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We read it, understand it, and implement it. Barakallahu feekum. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who implement the book of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala according to the sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam. According to the teaching of the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام, سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم تسليما كثيرا بارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.